Good morning, students. So you all know that our unit 5 is going on, and today we'll start the chapter 15, biodiversity and conservation. So what does biodiversity mean? Bios means life and diversity means forms. This term was given by Rosen in 1985, and its meaning is biological diversity is the occurrence of different types of ecosystems, different species of organisms, with the whole range of their variants, biotypes, and genes adapted to different climates, environment, along with their interactions and processes. So in this chapter, we'll study about magnitude of biodiversity, then genetic diversity, ecological diversity, species diversity, and patterns of biodiversity, importance of species diversity to ecosystem, causes of biodiversity losses, loss of biodiversity, and we learn why should we conserve biodiversity. So in this chapter, we'll study about biodiversity and conservation of biodiversity. What are strategies in situ conservation, ex situ conservation in detail? The term biodiversity was popularized by sociobiologist Edward Wilson in 1992. The degree of biodiversity is quite staggering. There are some 20,000 species of ants alone, 3 lakh species of beetles, 28,000 species of fishes, and 20,000 species of orchids. So it's very difficult to understand why are there so many species of a single type of organisms like ants or beetles. How has this diversification appeared in nature? Was it present all the time, or is it only of recent origin? Is this biodiversity useful to humans? What is the importance of this biodiversity to biosphere? What term would it cause to biosphere, and how human interest is there if biodiversity is reduced? So biodiversity refers to the variety of life forms and habitats found in a defined area. It also represents a totality of genes, species, and ecosystem of a given region. As I have told you in the previous slide, that biodiversity term was given by Edward Wilson to describe the diversity at all levels of biological organization, ranging from macromolecules inside the cell to biomes. It's of three interrelated hierarchical levels: genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecological diversity or community diversity. First of all, we'll study about genetic diversity. It is the diversity in number and types of genes, as well as chromosomes present in different species and the variations in the genes and their alleles in the same species. On an average, a bacteriophage has 100 genes, mycoplasma has 450 to 700 genes, Escherichia coli has 4000 genes, and Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Baker's yeast or brewer yeast, which we commonly is called, has 6,000 genes. Drosophila melanogaster, commonly called fruit fly, has 30,000 genes. Oryza stiva, 32,000 to 50,000 genes. And Homo sapiens are having 30,000 to 40,000 or 35,000 to 45,000 genes. Variations in the genes of a species increase with increase in size and environmental parameters of the habitat. It results in the formation of polymorphs. So, as we all know, that medicinal plant Wolfia vomitalia, growing in different Himalayan ranges, show differences in potency and concentration of active chemical called rizopine due to genetic diversity. Likewise, human beings have exploited this genetic diversity in raising numerous varieties of domesticated plants and animals. India has more than 50,000 genetically diverse varieties of rice and 1,000 varieties of mango. Genetic diversity also helps in speciation or evolution of new species. The diversity at a species level is called species diversity. So western ghats have greater amphibian species diversity as compared to eastern ghats. Species diversity is the variety in the number and richness of the species of a region. The number of species per unit area is called species richness. Number of individuals of different species represent different species equability. Communities where species are represented by more or less equal number of individuals exhibit evenness. Others where one or more species have more individuals than others show dominance or unevenness. So species diversity is product of both species richness and evenness or equability. That is species richness weighed by species evenness. Species diversity depends upon the number and richness of the species of a particular region. So species richness can be counted by the number of species per unit. So the diversity present at the ecosystem level is called ecological diversity. At the ecosystem level, India, for instance, with its deserts, rainforest, mangroves, coral reefs, wetlands, estuaries, and alpine meadows, has the greater ecosystem diversity than a Scandinavian country like Norway. It means that in our country, we have different types of habitats. In this picture, we can see different types of habitats, rainforest, mangroves, and estuary and coral reef areas. So it has been taken millions of years of evolution to accumulate this rich diversity in nature, but we could lose all this wealth in less than two centuries if the present rate of species losses continue. Biodiversity and its conservation are now vital environmental issues of international concern as more and more people around the world begin to realize the critical importance of biodiversity for our survival and well-being of this planet.